Bats play an important role in the natural balance of many ecosystems. There has been a growing concern about the bat population in the United States, mainly due to white nose syndrome. Today, we recognize bridges as potential roosting locations. This recognition is critical to starting to understand how, why, and when bats use bridges as roosting sites. A recent study at Iowa State University's Institute for Transportation, or INTRANS, used a unique research approach that has helped to better understand what type of bridges are most likely to be used by bats as roosting locations. Researchers identified those locations based on bridge characteristics, such as local topography and habitat availability, characteristics that increase the likelihood of bat roosting. This information can be useful to transportation agencies as they plan bridge replacement, repair, and rehabilitation projects in order to comply with federal environmental requirements. Today, we will offer information to help bridge inspectors and other transportation officials begin to identify the signs of bat roosting locations. Before going to the bridge site, it's helpful to know what types of bridges may be most likely to be a roosting location. The probability of bat roosting on bridges increases significantly when structures are pre-stressed concrete continuous, which is most likely. But the probability is also high when structures are pre-stressed concrete or steel continuous. The likelihood of finding bats also rises with increased superstructure height above ground, with increased superstructure depth, with increased wetland coverage within 0.1 mile radius of the structure, and with increased number of potential bat species at the location. But it's important to remember any bridge could be a roosting location. Look for places on bridges that have hidden or secluded spaces. That could include crevices, large cracks, girders, expansion joints, or simply any spot that resembles cavern or cave-like conditions. Now, let's go look for bat roosting locations. That may not be as easy as it may sound. Of the 517 structures inspected for the INTRANS study, only 24% had a bat presence. Even if there is no evidence of bat presence at a bridge, it's important to keep checking during inspections because bats could later roost at that location. But if a bridge has a known bat presence, it's good to document the evidence in subsequent inspections by photographs and inspection notes, as bats may be more likely to return to the same place, particularly for maternity roosts. Some agencies, like Minnesota Department of Transportation, have bridge inspection elements that help document bat presence over time. Also, during the INTRANS study, there were very few actual bat sightings. What you are more likely to encounter is evidence of bat presence, such as urine staining or droppings. While you are doing a scour assessment, for example, it's useful to look for that visual evidence to quickly confirm bat presence. Here, at this pre-stressed concrete bridge in Marion County, you can see the urine stains look like brown splotches. The staining can also look like long lengths of browning, and the splotches can be various sizes. You can see the guano looks like small, lumpy pellets. The pellets are typically black or dark brown in color, but older guano can look gray. The pellets may be in large or small piles on the ground, or it may be found on bridge walls or support beams. The guano will often be spotted near or below evidence of staining. Bat droppings also will crumble into a powder when crushed. For the big brown bat, the most common species in Iowa, the pellets are about 1/2 inch long. For the small brown bat, also found in Iowa, the pellets are about the size of rice grains, but more lumpy in shape. Most bats that are found in Iowa are the same size as the big brown bat or smaller. The pellets could also be confused for red droppings, so look carefully to confirm all available evidence of bats. If droppings are the only evidence, inspect closer to identify if they are more likely from rats or mice. Rats and mice have smoother and sturdier droppings that tend to be tapered at the ends. Bat droppings are lumpy, tend to crumble, and are rounded at the ends. If there are no obvious signs, or if it's not clear that you have found the presence of bats, you can also turn to technology. infrared cameras, such as this one, or ecometer tools, such as this, can be used to help identify bats at bridges. Both are available, as you can see, for use with smartphones, and they are easy to use. Armed with this information, we hope transportation agency officials better understand what to look out for at bridges to avoid the harassment, injury, or killing of federally threatened or endangered bat species.